Now this is a 22 weeks pregnancy in which we are seeing, at least you can see the urinary bladder. This is the cervix. This is the cervix that measures approximately 4.52 centimeters. And this is the penis. This is the penis, this one. This area, this is the scrotal sac. This is the penis. Now this is the umbilical cord. And this is the femur. So it is a beach presentation. Between the thighs, you can see this is the scrotum. This, you see femur. You see the urinary bladder. This is the urinary bladder. This is the heart. This is the stomach bubble. This is the liver. And this is the gallbladder. Probably, let's see. No, it's not the gallbladder, but impression is as if it is the gallbladder, which this being the portal vein. This is the portal vein, this is the gallbladder, this is the liver. And here we are in the chest region now. She has a bad history, obstetrical history. Just see that the cardiac activity at this point is ...147 to 150 beats per minute. Let's wait for some time and see that if there is any variation. And if possible, you will be able to see the respiration in the same view. Here you are, you saw one movement, second. This is the fetal movement, in fact. You saw three fetal movements. Four. Wait for some time, or other thing is that you see the rest of the fetus and then we'll come back and see whether it remains the same or there is some change, any change in the fetal cardiac activity. This is the fourth chamber view of the heart. Femur is, the mother is tense and so will be the fetus. It will affect the fetus. Now you see the beat is 144 per minute. So there is variation which is with the norm. This is the umbilical vein, stomach bubble. Now urinary bladder is in front of you. And this is the fetal body and chest, showing normality so far. Let's move ahead towards the head of the fetus. This is a breech presentation. This is the fetal head. The PPD is 5.4. That corresponds to the gestational age of 22 weeks. This is from where we take the bipyramidal diameter. going through the broken center of the broken forks. This is the fork cerebri, the thalami, the CSPs, and this is the cranium. So when we measure, we will go through the center from this way. Not from here, not from here, but through the center of the broken fork from outer to inner surface to get the vibratory diameter. The amniotic fluid is adequate. The internal loss is closed. This is the internal loss. This is the placenta. Now on the placenta is grade 2. And is posterior wall. So the placenta is posterior wall but above the os. Much above the os. Rather, it's a upper segment, posterior wall, upper segment placenta, and you can see that here we can get the umbilical fluid pocket. Now the umbilical fluid is by eye interpretation normal in amount. This is the transverse of the fetus, so we don't see any anterior abdominal wall defect. These are the vertebrae. This is the neck region. We do not see any focal growth in this region. Now we should see the vertebral column in totem, as she gives the history that one of the baby was born with meningocele. Now in this case, from cephalic to caudal, we do not see any such anomaly. This is the caudal end of the vertebral column. This is the vertebral column and this is the caudal end. So there is no outgrowth here. The heart is fine, the lungs are okay. These are the eyes. This is the eye. This is the eye. And now you see, this is the hand of the fetus, flexed hand of the fetus. You can measure the knuckles. This is the hand. The fetal movement. Is best viewed by the movement of the limbs. The femur, yes, the umbilical cord, two artery, one vein. It should be two artery, one vein to be normal. in transverse section, 1 artery, second artery, this is the vein. So umbilical cord is normal. This is the fundal region. I am going to apply some gel now. Fluid pocket, largest fluid pocket, this is the one, Meyer's. Four 4.8 centimeters, it should be at least 4, so it is with a normal. Now here you can see the movement of the limbs. This is the hand, this is the hand, this is the wrist joint. This is the other arm. So fetal activity is present. The calcification of the bones is still normal. This is a normal study at 22 weeks gestational age. These are the limbs, lower limbs. This is the aorta of the fetus. This is the aorta. And you can see its pulsations. The heart, the urinary bladder, these are the kidneys. This is a magnified view. So they will appear bigger to you. This is the one kidney. So you still saw one at least. Okay. The kidney was normal. The kidney urinary bladder normal, male fetus, transverse section of the abdomen, anterior wall intact, these are the eyes, this is one, this is second one, Meyer edge, and the eye gives you 3.4 centimeters. measurements. The cranium is okay. Okay, let's see the cardiac activity once again. You see the movements of the fetus, they are present. You can definitely see the variation in the heartbeat, which is within normal. And this comes in the biophysical profile. Actually, in the biophysical profile, we see the variation in the heartbeat. Then we see the amniotic fluid pocket, we did saw that. And we see that the amniotic, we saw that the amniotic fluid pocket was 4.8 centimeters, 4 up to 4 is taken as normal. Then we saw the movement of the limbs as well as the hands. So this is a four-chamber view of the heart. And the cardiac activity now is again 144 beats per minute. The stomach bubble, the umbilical vein, the liver, the urinary bladder. You saw the sex of the fetus, that is the XY. Here it is. You saw the penis. Umbilical fluid was normal. Umbilical cord is normal. Now this is the hand. You can see the movement. These things come in the category of biophysical profile, and biophysical profile takes a lot of time to be performed, and one thing left is the breathing movements of the fetus. We have, now this is the extension of the fetal, yeah, here you are. If you are concentrating on this region, it will show you the movement of the fetal fingers, hand fingers, hand joints. We did saw the flexion and extension movements of the fetus, which also again is a part of the biophysical profile. So in this patient, the biophysical profile is normal. This again, you see the movement. So this is how we perform a biophysical profile, and it takes sufficient time of the sonologist while other patients remain waiting. So I'm going to conclude with the impression that this is a normal pregnancy of 32 weeks. That of a second trimester pregnancy, normal. The fetal movements as well as the breathing. There should be 3 at least in 30 minutes. This is how you will do it. This is the liver. This is the heart, chest. This is the respiratory movement, the one yourself. This is the respiratory movement here. So this is the biophysical profile done that of a 22 weeks gestational age, yes, of a pregnant female with a bad obstructive history. She had given birth to one baby with meningocele and hydrocele as well. Now this time, this is a male fetus and is normal. Thank you very much.